You know where you are? You're in the jungle, baby!
Looks like a nice place to stage dive. It's a song about a friend of mine. Might even fit a lot of people here who's, since you can't find the one you want, your best friend is cocaine. Well, this particular girl's name is Michelle. We'll be right back. to do a song we ain't played in a long time. Just because it feels like something to do. This will be an unspoken dedication. This song is called Don't Cry.
I know.
This is a song for those people who, guys and gals who came there looking for something they want. This is about having it all. This is Rocket Queen. We'll be right back. They sell Night Train around here? So you know what that is, right? It's a real cheap bottle of shit wine. That's why most of these wine hoes are knocked on their fucking ass. It's pretty good shit. Let's go for a fucking ride.
Yeah.
Now, if you know of us, if you have known of us, then you know we recently, a couple months ago, lost a friend of ours. A little over a month ago, I OD'd, and I ended up in a hospital called Cedars-Sinai. I was in a coma for about 2 days. When I got out of the hospital, the first person I saw was a guy named Todd Crew. Todd used to be in a band called Jet Boy, and one of the reasons he got kicked out... Jet Boy sucks. One of the reasons he got kicked out was for hanging out with us. I think we were more friends than the people he knew all his fucking life. When I got out of the hospital, the first person I saw was Todd, and I really didn't want to see anybody I knew because I didn't know if I had any friends left. Todd came up to me and gave me a hug and said, "You can't do this to the family, man." 2 weeks later, Todd OD'd here in New York. Now, we try doing this song without dedicating to Todd, and every time we feel too fucking guilty, we end up doing it anyway. And a friend told me that we won't get over it until it happens again. So until then, this is for Todd, and this is Knocking on Heaven's Door. next one. All right, here we go.
Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door.
Thank you for helping.
I'd like to thank Dave Mustaine for that brief appearance. Long live Megadeth. I want to take a minute to introduce the members of the band.
On his new Chet Atkins guitar, Mr. Izzy Stradlin. The punk rocker of the band, Mr. Duff McKagan. On the drums, and faster than a rabbit, Mr. Steven Adler. And straight from the depths of hell, our creature from the Black Lagoon, this is Slash. But he's a lot cuter, I think.
So we finally make the Ritz, right? This has been the most looked forward to gig of the whole East Coast tour, I have to admit. Not to put any of the other places down. But anyway, so I'm not gonna fuck around. When I was a little bit younger, everybody said, you go to New York, if you can play New York and play the Ritz and kick ass and get everybody on your side, then you're doing all right. So. But you guys just seem a little laid back. How hardcore does this crowd get if you're really asked to do it, man? Let me see some spotlights on the kids out here, man. Fuck. All right, well, this is the one thrash song in the set, you know, a little bit more thrash than all the other ones are. So I just want to see how far gone this crowd can get. Anyway, Axel's going to dedicate it, right?
I'd like to dedicate this to Robert Christgau. Why don't you blow yourself away, fuckface? Because you're fucking crazy!
Yeah.
living here or in LA or basically anywhere, when it gets rough, you wish you could go somewhere else, place else. It's our last song. So for right now, we're going to go to Paradise City.
Yeah.
Now shut the fuck up, right? Hey, fuckers! Suck on Guns and fucking Roses!
Now in these last few minutes, I'll do my best to make a point for what it's worth. Got a lot of people, a lot of magazines, and a lot of things going, it's a glam band, it's a metal band, it's a glam metal band, it's a hard rock band, it's a thrash band, it's a... Fuck it. It doesn't make a good goddamn whether my hair's up, my hair's down, or I'm fucking bald.
It's all fucking rock and roll to me. And if you got a problem, why don't you write a letter to your fucking mama Jean?